China, a country moving at an unprecedented rate in terms of development, whether it's space, artificial intelligence, or any in-house production projects, the country is rising on every side. So let's discuss about China's future megaprojects in today's video of DiscoverZen. China is a country in East Asia. It is the world's most populous country with a population of around 1.4 billion in 2019, covering approximately 9.6 million square kilometers or 3.7 million square miles. It is the world's third largest country by area. As a one-party state led by the Chinese Communist Party, it exercises jurisdiction over 22 provinces, 5 autonomous regions, 4 direct controlled municipalities, which are Beijing, Tianjin, Shanghai, and Chongqing, and the special administrative regions of Hong Kong and Macau. China wants to make its capital, Beijing, the center of the world's largest supercity by merging 3 provinces into one continuous megapolis of 130 million people. That is 6 times the population of New York. The region is called Jingjinji. It will tie together the cities in the 3 provinces along the Bohai Bay Rim using advanced communications networks, new high-speed rail and subway lines, and better highways. Reports say that Beijing's focus is on culture and technology, Tianjin is slowly becoming a research base for manufacturing, and Hebei will be the new home of many of the federal bureaucracy jobs that will be relocated from the capital. The project has the full backing of President Xi Jinping to catch the area up to China's more economically prosperous regions, like what Shanghai and Nanjing have got going on in the Yangtze River Delta. Covering roughly the total land area of the US state of Kansas, Jingjinji will be unlike anything seen before in the history of mankind. Artificial intelligence in China. China is on its way to becoming the first global superpower for artificial intelligence. The country has the most ambitious AI strategy of all nations and provides the most resources worldwide for its implementation. China combines a gigantic amount of data with talent, companies, research, and capital to build the world's leading AI ecosystem. In 2017, the State Council of the People's Republic of China, also known as the Central People's Government, published the Artificial Intelligence Development Plan. This strategy is part of the even bigger national Made in China 2025 plan. With these plans, China aims to become the world's largest economic power and to provide its people with adequate prosperity guaranteed by a politically stable system. In addition, China is ensuring that economic, military, and diplomatic interests are safeguarded in this way. AI is aimed to connect and upgrade the entire Chinese industry by 2025. Artificial intelligence will produce goods and control companies while balancing supply and demand. Additionally, AI will help the central government monitor and control its own population. Artificial intelligence will be used to protect military and digital interests, but it will also enable the population to live a good life in safety. China is pursuing a centrally controlled strategy with hyperlocal implementation. Values and goals are set from above and resources are made available. At the local level of municipalities, cities, and provinces, regional administrations compete for the new AI clusters. The result is a national and regional administrative state that works closely with research, investors, and industry to build a successful AI ecosystem. The implementation of the national strategy varies greatly from region to region. While cities such as Tianjin and Shanghai have already launched multi-billion dollar AI city venture capital funds and had entire districts and islands built for new AI companies, other provinces are still in the process of learning and development. Overall, China is doing many things right. The provision of legal frameworks, resources, and goals, coupled with local freedom to adapt, is creating a rapidly growing AI industry. At the same time, the state provides incentives for the administration and politicians to assert themselves in the AI industry and to recommend themselves for higher tasks. To achieve this, government takes an analytical approach and is aware of its own weaknesses and strengths. Hundreds of new AI professorships have been established, and hundreds of thousands of study places have been created. China now has a mature and efficient startup ecosystem in which younger AI companies are building. There is sufficient capital from both the state and private sectors for the establishment, scaling, and growth of AI startups in China. A relevant example of the application and implementation of artificial intelligence in China is the social score. Basically, it reflects the idea of controlling and managing a society, with machines instead of people. Every country has laws, cultural norms, social morals, and social agreements. The police, courts, politicians, administrations, media, and citizens are involved in a constant dialogue. It determines what we define as right or wrong. In China, this task has partly been taken over by a machine. The machine decides on correct and incorrect behavior. The social score is a system that collects all kinds of data about citizens and companies. The system then sorts, analyzes, evaluates, interprets, and implements human-suggested actions based on it. In concrete terms, this means that if you wait at a red light, you get positive points. If you pay your taxes and bills on time, you get positive points. If you are socially involved and accept the rules, you also get positive points. If you have a good social score, you get unsolicited benefits for your social behavior. These include, for example, faster visa application processing and more freedom to travel. When dating online, algorithms higher prioritize their own profile. Banks offer lower interest rates for company loans or private real estate purchases. People with high social score are promoted faster and get better job offers. However, people who go red, cut off someone while driving, spit on the street, or stick their chewing gum under their seat, they get negative points. Anyone who criticizes the state on social media or pays their bills too late also receive negative points. A poor social score thus reduces the probability of finding a date, earning money, or traveling the country. Space industry in China. The space program of the People's Republic of China is directed by the China National Space Administration, CNSA. Its technological roots can be traced back to the late 1950s when China began a ballistic missile program in response to perceived American and later Soviet threats. However, the first Chinese crewed space program only began several decades later when an accelerated program of technological development culminated in Yang Liwei's successful 2003 flight aboard Shenzhou 5. This achievement made China the third country to independently send humans into space. Plans currently include a permanent Chinese space station by 2022 and crewed expeditions to the moon. And according to a recent report, they even want to compete with SpaceX's Starlink by launching up to 10,000 satellites in the low Earth orbit to provide low-latency internet. The country is currently trailing Russia and the US, and is set to become a space superpower by 2030. It has been expanding its network of military intelligence satellites. Last year, it conducted 32 successful rocket launches as per the Center for Strategic and International Studies, a Washington-based think tank. This puts China on top for the second year in a row, exceeding the 21 launches in the US in 2019. With the new Tian space station plan, Beijing is set to create another battleground. It would be the first crewed space station. Reportedly, the launch of its core module on a Long March 5B will be in 2021. The space station will orbit at an altitude of around 380 kilometers with an inclination of between 41 and 43 degrees. Overall development. When it comes to the overall fast-paced developing nation, there is no match with China. The country is already a hub of electronics assembly, the best and cheap in-house silicon industry, going to rule the world of artificial intelligence by 2030, and even have the technology to compete with other giants in the space industry. So, what's left? Well, nothing much, but there could be a general concern about privacy when China deploys full-fledged AI systems. Since the country's general population doesn't care much about their privacy, it doesn't matter for their government as well as the Chinese companies. So, we can easily predict that China is developing very fast and there is no stopping by. Now let's discuss about another country, Dubai and their plans to outlive oil. Well, that sounds like a different topic to discuss on DiscoverZen.